Welcome, my name is Alejandro Duto, and this is the first ISDC video in the series about the Operation Crossroads shipwrecks in the Bikini and the Kwajalein Atolls. What a series we have ahead of us. With so much content to share, we've structured the series of videos totaling 9 episodes, detailing each aspect of diving the shipwreck sunk by the nuclear detonations Able and Baker. This particular video, which is an introductory episode, will cover an introduction to the Marshall Islands, home to the Bikini and Kwajalein Atolls, covering the logistics of the trip, including the planning, the routes, and the necessary preparations. In order to better understand the wrecks and the history of this place, we'll have a brief overview about Operation Crossroads. There will be a section about diving the atolls where we talk about the weather, the diving conditions, the dive gear we need to have in mind, and the dive profiles overall. And lastly, we'll be talking about the shipwrecks that we'll be diving on our next videos. In the following videos, we'll deep dive into the detailed explorations of each of the iconic shipwrecks found here. If the detailed videos are already available, you'll find the link in the description below or in a pop-up card up on the screen. If they're not available, you may want to subscribe to the channel and get notified whenever they come available. On the upcoming episodes, we will cover the USS Saratoga, an aircraft carrier, the IJN Nagato, a Japanese battleship, the Prinz Eugen, a German heavy cruiser, the USS Apogon, a submarine, the USS Anderson and the USS Lamson, both destroyers, and the USS Arkansas, a US battleship. Then, the final episode of this series will be an in-depth look at Operation Crossroads itself, focusing more on the history of the project than on the diving, but this will provide a complete framework of what happened at Bikini Atoll in 1946. So let's talk a little bit about the Marshall Islands themselves. The Marshall Islands are part of the broader Micronesia region on the Pacific Ocean and played a significant role in World War II and in the Cold War. Micronesia itself encompasses a vast expanse of ocean, dotted with numerous island nations, included the Marshall Islands, the Federated States of Micronesia, Palau, all three of them well known for diving, also Kiribati, specifically the Gilbert Islands, the Northern Mariana Islands, Guam, Nauru, and the Wake Islands. The Marshall Islands are home to more than 42,000 people. The capital and largest city is Majuro, which is located on the atoll with the same name. This nation consists of 29 atolls and 5 islands, with 24 of the atolls being inhabited. This video series focuses primarily on 2 atolls, Kwajalein, which is the largest in the country, with 16 square kilometers, and a lagoon that covers 1,700 square kilometers, and the uninhabited Bikini Atoll, where the nuclear tests took place. Our adventure begins with an island hopper flight, which can be boarded both on Guam or in Honolulu. It arrives at Kwajalein Atoll, home to a key US military base and the Buchholz Army airfield. Civilians are, of course, not allowed to stay on the base, so all non-US military personnel is immediately transferred to the ferry station and then head to Ibai Island nearby. Ibai Island is densely populated, primarily by Marshallese that were displaced during the military expansion, both Japanese and American, during the war, and this will be our home for a couple of days until the ship that will take us to Bikini Atoll arrives. Now, Bikini Atoll, the second one of the atolls, is approximately 242 miles, that is 390 kilometers to the northwest, and is famous for its post-war nuclear tests, which is why the atoll has no permanent population. Today, Bikini Atoll is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and where the most of our shipwreck exploration will take place. Getting there is probably the first challenge of the journey. We departed by boat from Ibai in Kwajalein, and arrived at Bikini around 28 to 36 hours later which depended a lot on ocean conditions. Before the nuclear tests in Bikini Atoll, all of the local population was relocated, and later on there were two main efforts to repopulate the atoll. First one in 1970s, and later on the early 2000s. Both of them halted due to high radiation levels and costs. In the early 2000s, a dive shop, Bikini Atoll Divers, established a dive center and a hotel to attract tourists, leveraging the atoll's unique status as a wreck diving destination. However, the dive center and hotel ultimately closed in 2008 due to high operational costs, logistical challenges, and the ongoing concern about radiation levels. Lastly, caretakers were brought to maintain the atoll and specifically the island, but left due to funding issues. While short visits like ours are possible, it is not considered safe for permanent habitation due to elevated cesium-137 radiation levels. Let's briefly discuss Operation Crossroads, the nuclear tests that created this underwater museum in the first place. As mentioned, there will be a specific video covering Operation Crossroads in detail if you're interested in learning more about that story. Operation Crossroads was a series of nuclear tests conducted by the United States at Bikini Atoll in the Marshall Islands in 1946. It was designed to investigate the effects of nuclear weapons on warships. The operation consisted in two tests: Able, which was an airdrop bomb, and Baker, which was an underwater detonation. These tests marked the first nuclear explosions since the bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and were the first to be publicly announced and filmed. The results demonstrated the immense power of nuclear weapons and significantly impacted future naval strategies and international nuclear policies. A fleet of 93 target ships, plus support ships, was assembled in Bikini Lagoon and were hit with the two detonations of a Fat Man-type implosion weapons. They were similar to the ones dropped in Nagasaki in 1945. The target fleet included two aircraft carriers, five battleships, four US battleships and the Japanese Nagato, four cruisers, two US cruisers, the German heavy cruiser Prinz Eugen and the Japanese cruiser Sakawa, eight submarines, 12 destroyers, 19 transports, 40 landing crafts of various types, and three support ships, two oilers and a dry dock. After the two explosions, 23 ships sunk. The first explosion, Able, sunk the Sakawa, the USS Anderson, the USS Lamson, the USS Carlisle, and the USS Gilliam. And later on, Baker, the underwater detonation, sunk the USS Saratoga, the USS Arkansas, the Nagato, the USS Apogon, the USS Pilotfish, and additionally, one LST, one LCI, one LCBP, one LCM, seven LCTs, and two support ships, an oiler and the floating dry dock. It is worth noting that LSM-60 was obliterated, since it was the ship from which the bomb Baker was suspended from. Also, as you can see, the Prinz Eugen was not sunk by the bombs, but it was later scuttled by the US Navy on Kwajalein Atoll. As you can imagine, some of the ships on this list are the ones we dived and the ones we're going to be showing you in the series. So without further ado, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about diving. Exploring Bikini Atoll and diving the Prinz Eugen in Kwajalein offered unparalleled experience for our group, combining history, adventure, and natural beauty. However, these dives require rigorous planning and preparation due to the challenging logistics and unique conditions of these sites. Bikini Atoll is an isolated, uninhabited paradise, meaning that there is no local support available for divers. Each expedition must be entirely self-sufficient, with exhaustive emergency precautions taken in advance. Remember, there is no medical assistance whatsoever. Given the complexity and remote nature of these dives, preparation and planning are crucial. Divers must be experienced and prepared for this trip in the best possible way. Having a technical diving certification is a must, preferably in CCR, that is a rebreather. A Mod 2 level, extended range if you're an open circuit diver, and have an advanced rec diving certification to handle the challenging depths and conditions is also a must. Within Bikini Atoll, all of the shipwrecks, including the most iconic ones, lie at depths ranging from 50 to 53 meters approximately, that is 164 to 174 feet. Given the cost and logistical challenge of obtaining helium, closed circuit rebreathers are highly recommended for these dives. Careful planning of gas mixes, decompression, and emergency procedures is essential for safety. The diluent gas we used was 1645, and average dive run times extended to about 2 hours, allowing us to have ample time to explore these historical wrecks and enough decompression time to make each dive safe. Also, normally, an extra 10 to 15 minutes decompression or safety stop was added at 6 meters or 20 feet. Have in mind that the closest decompression chamber is about 30 hours away, necessitating extremely conservative dive profiles and careful planning to mitigate the risks. Navigation between the sites in the lagoon is minimal, as the ships were deliberately positioned close together for the nuclear tests. As you can see here in the map, we were about 3 miles away from the Bikini Island shore. Despite being subjected to two nuclear blasts, many of the shipwrecks appear to be in good shape. However, ongoing decay is a constant concern, with occasional cracking sounds heard during the dives. The wrecks are also still losing oil, adding another layer of complexity and caution to the dives. At this point, it's obvious that these wrecks were not designed as an artificial reef, which makes penetration dives particularly hazardous. While they serve as genuine underwater museums, rich with artifacts and devices from that era, they also pose numerous risks, including silting, the oil, as we said, dangling debris, and rusted sharp metal. Extreme caution is crucial to avoid disturbing silt or encountering unstable structures. The risk of silting is significant, as many internal sections have no means of cleaning the rust through currents or anything like that. The underwater conditions in Bikini Atoll can vary, but we were very, very fortunate to have fantastic visibility and a temperature that averaged 30 degrees Celsius or 86 in Fahrenheit, from surface to the bottom, providing a very, very comfortable condition for the extended dives. Being inside the atoll creates a condition where no current is present at these depths. Now, the Prinz Eugen, located in Kwajalein, presents a different dive profile. With a maximum depth of 35 meters, 115 feet, is more accessible than the Bikini wrecks. However, careful planning remains essential. Lastly, no discussion would be complete without mentioning the diversity and abundance of marine life that has colonized these historical wrecks. In the waters around the Bikini wrecks, divers often encounter curious sharks, and the wrecks are adorned with a vibrant array of fish, creating a unique blend of history and natural beauty. All of the points mentioned here are general facts that apply to diving on all the Bikini sites. We'll cover the specific details of each of the dives on the wrecks in the upcoming videos, providing detailed information and guidance. Now let's talk about the shipwrecks themselves. As mentioned, a total of 93 ships participated in the nuclear detonations of Operation Crossroads. For now, we'll cover the ones that we dived, which were the USS Saratoga, a Lexington-class aircraft carrier with 270 meters or 888 feet of length. The Nagato, a Japanese battleship with 215 meters or 708 feet of length. The Prinz Eugen, an Admiral Hyperclass heavy cruiser from Germany with 212 meters or 697 feet of length. The USS Apogon, a Balao-class submarine with 94 meters or 311 feet of length. The USS Anderson, a Sims-class destroyer with 106 meters or 348 feet of length. The USS Lamson, a Mahan-class destroyer with 104 meters or 341 feet of length. The USS Arkansas, a USA dreadnought battleship with 171 meters or 561 feet of length. Now that we covered all the general aspects of diving the Operation Crossroads wrecks and introduce you to the shipwrecks, before we wrap up, I'd like to hear what you think of the video. This is not our usual format, so please leave your comments below and let me know what you think. If you like it, of course, give it a thumbs up. Also, remember to subscribe and get the updates for when the next videos come out. Thank you so much for being there, and see you in the USS Saratoga video.